this was my uncle's idea 15 years ago. He started this Cola Vita challenge around the world, and Brazil was the first one. We thought that this is a way of giving back after all we have received from the food service. Here is even more exciting because it's a public school, and it's exciting to do something for students of this age. It's a, you know, as you know, it's a critical age, the high school age, so it's important to push those students to do more, to fight, and to work out. We have been involved with the school in different level in the years, but this year they asked me to join the board, and one of the idea, you know, came to my mind, of course, was this Cola Vita concorso that we have done for many years with Brazil. This year the board has chosen Tom Colicchio and Dana Cowan to judge the competition. We asked them to judge this challenge, and they were super excited. They were no accident. They said yes.
It was fantastic. And these are young, you know, cooks and students, and they were really, the dishes they put together were really sophisticated. I was actually not expecting this level of sophistication from the dishes that we just had. I expected, you know, a lot of mistakes, and there weren't a whole lot of mistakes. For the most part, like, we had a polenta cake, and the cake was, you know, beautifully cooked, really moist, delicious. We had another soft polenta with a mushroom ragu that was really, really good. Tiny bit salty, but that was it. And so what impressed me was they were able to conceive of some really good dishes and execute them at a very high level. And you don't often see that with someone as young as these kids. So, yeah, they did a nice job.
I thought the kids did really, really well. Everything was delicious. It might be because of the ingredients. They started from a good place, and they conceptualized the dishes in a very clean and clear way. So we knew what we were eating. It was familiar. And they didn't mess up. Sometimes it takes just that. But overall, Tom and I sat there and said, oh my God, this is so good. This is so good. He's, of course, a star of Top Chef. I've had the pleasure of being on there. We've eaten a lot of competition food. It's very, very difficult. And these guys just nailed it.
Those two students, the one, are the one that are going to get the most out of this, according to the instructors.
We cooked a fried polenta stuffed with cheese with the bolognese sauce topped with the herb salad.
Freshman year, we made a bolognese, so I was like, oh, we should do that. And then I was like, I didn't think anybody was going to do a ball, so I was like, a ball with cheese in the middle, because everybody likes cheese.
It was a tremendous opportunity to work with the students. It was surprising to see their passion, the incredible knowledge that they have, and how much time and effort they put into practicing their dishes. All the teams had something in particular that were impressive, whether it was the presentation or the dedication to the dish or the flavor development that they had or the research about traditional Italian cuisine that they did. So each team had something that was very impressive about them.
Those two students, they won. They are going to Italy. So what we're going to do, they're going to have a VIP tour of the city in Rome. They will be able to eat and to have hands-on in the most important restaurant in Rome, as well as in Perugia and in Molise. In Perugia, as you know, we distribute for United States Perugina chocolate. So Perugina will host them and will have the master chocolatier teaching them for a day. After that, we'll head to Molise. We'll line up for them different experience. It's going to be nice. They'll have fun and they learn a lot. And then we'll go back to Rome for another day in Rome.
Since we're just juniors and we're like learning, slowly learning how to use our soft skills, use our knife skills, how to cook in time. And Italy, I feel like it will help us with the food that we'll eat, how to use certain flavors, what goes well together. And I hope we learn many, many things.
When we thought about the Cola Vita Challenge, we didn't think about a one-year edition, but multiple years, so long-term. And having seen how excited and how passionate were the students about this project and this challenge, even push us even to do longer.